All right, a small interruption. Yeah, where do we see goblet cells? Goblet cells are those mucus secreting cells and conjunctiva, trachea, colon, stomach. They are the classical locations, not in the case of the esophagus. What is the root value of the radial nerve? A straight forward sensitive cushion, C5 to T1 is the classical root value of the radial nerve. As all of you know, crutch palsy is the typical palsy which occurred because of C5 to T1, a very widespread root value. So we need to be quite sure on the various root values. Ulnar nerve is C7, 8, T1. Axillary nerve is C5, C6. Thoracodorsal is C6, 7, 8. But the only one which has got a very extensive root value would be the radial nerve out of all of them, is what need to be remembered. Now, what is the artery of the forearm? It is the ulnar artery, which is the larger of the two terminal branches of the brachial artery, which is called the artery of the upper arm. Okay, doctor, shoot me an answer for this question. Physiological jaundice is not present until how many hours after the birth? Before which, if it is present, it is basically no more called as physiological, but it is called as pathological. 24 is an answer coming from Dr. Manavi. Any other answers? Anandapur says 48. Is there any other answer other than that? Who will give me the correct answer? 24, even Shravya, Varangal, Shankar, Vizag, everyone say. But doctor, physiological jaundice versus pathological jaundice. Pathological is present within the first 24 hours of life, and physiological is not present until 72 hours of birth. Then what is present between 24 to 72 hours? So that is the reason, that is the whole fix of this question. First 24 hours is pathological, no doubt, but you expect it to be physiological if it is after 72 hours. Then bilirubin more than 0.5 is possible in pathological, not physiological. Persisting beyond 1 week in term infants and 2 weeks in preterm infants, the jaundice is pathological, because physiological results by 1 week in case of term infants is what need to be basically remembered. That's right. So first 24 hours pathological is fine, but not until 72 hours is the physiological. That is what need to be remembered. Single liners are dangerous poisoned arrows. If there is a mismatch, then the arrow straight lands on the jugular in the exam hall. So that's the reason we need to be quite careful. Okay, what is the normal pH of the blood is an important question. It is 7.35 to 7.45 is what you have to remember. For how long monocytes remain in the circulation? For about 1 to 3 days, for about 72 hours, they remain in the circulation is what need to be remembered. It is the HbA which is the predominant form. In all these three forms, bicarbonate, dissolved form, everywhere, carbon dioxide is transported. Ferritin is the one which is used to know how is the iron content, transferrin is the iron transporter protein, and in the iron deficiency you have a low serum iron with a low ferritin, whereas in the case of anemia of chronic disease, ferritin levels are elevated in a microcytic anemia is what need to be remembered. Then coming to the next question, when do you want to, this is a straight simple question to all of you, when do you want to treat the unconjugated hyperbilirubinemia with the phototherapy or exchange transfusion? What is the threshold value? More than how much you want to treat? If it is a premature baby, more than how much you want to treat? These are the two questions you are now going to give me, two answers for these questions. When do you want to treat unconjugated hyperbilirubinemia? Dr. Abhi says 15 and 10. Shankar says 20. Kirti says more than 15. I need two answers. Anandapur says 20. Manavi says 20 and 15. Dilip says 25 and 20. Let us see. Normal babies, more than 20 is an indication for phototherapy. In case of preterm infants, between 10 to 15 milligrams per deciliter we give the phototherapy much earlier, is what I want to underscore to all of you. Now 2, 7, 9, 10, they are all the vitamin K dependent clotting factors, is what need to be remembered. Glutamate at the position 6 of the beta globin chain replaced with valin is what you classically come across. 1.33 ml of oxygen is carried by every gram of hemoglobin is a very well known fact. Now what is the difference between serum and plasma? Very reasonable question. Serum has the same composition like plasma, except that the fibrinogen factor 2, 5 and 8 are basically removed and serum has higher serotonin content. That is the fundamental difference between serum and that of the plasma. So now for 4 different exams in the country, DNB is the common guru. DNB primary, post primary in June and December. NEET exam, it is the governing body. For the foreign medical graduate exams, MCA screening test also, DNB is the guru. So the entire question bank is fundamentally what the DNB decides. So the questions initially may not be very complex. They may be single liners as what you might have seen in the NEET PG sample questions. And probably you might have taken recently DNB primary exams also. Question paper is more or less like this. Will you be more happy with this kind of a paper or the regular tough paper where we torture you with our mock tests? Which one do you want? I think these are more difficult to crack. Here they look very simple, but if you don't know, you don't know kind of questions. There is no scope for any guesswork. So doctor, hemophilia B, it is a factor 9, which is fundamentally deficient. Okay, shoot me one answer, doctor. Neuroblast tumor is an embryonal tumor, and more than half of the patients, what is the age group? They will be less than how many years of age? Anandapur says 3 years. Any other answers? Any other thought process? Manavi says 6 years. Very wide range you are giving, madam. Kirti says 3 years. Dilip says 1 to 5. There is no range. I am talking precisely cut and dry. One value. Hyderabad says 5 years. Vizag says, how come this question such a simple one? I thought 2 years. More than half of the patients are less than 2 years of age in the case of the neuroblastoma. Why you want to remember that? Which is the tumor arising from the kidney which is seen between 2 to 5 years? It is the Wilms tumor. It is that embryonally originated tumor that is commonly seen between 2 to 5 years. Less than 2 years is the age group of the neuroblastoma, which you have to be very clear, doctor. If there is no NEET PG, no problem. If it is only state PG, March tak humko time hai. Agar NEET PG hai to 2 years, 2 to 5 years. You have to give me precise answer. Now doctor, universal recipients, AB group, very easy question. It is the thromboplastin, factor 7, which are the part of the extrinsic pathway. What is Hageman's factor? It is the factor 12, which is called as Hageman. Hageman's factor, which is also called as the glass factor, which is the initial reaction in the intrinsic system. Yesterday evening we had a hematology class for the medicine final year students. We discussed heparin, warfarin, coagulation pathway, everything. That is all available in the videos in this free channel, in the video library of the free channel. It is available, yesterday's discussion. If you did this question wrong, take a chance to review. Factor 7 is PT, 2, 5, 10 is both PT, ABTT. 8, 9, 12, everything is ABTT. Factor 13 is neither PT nor ABTT. That's the reason what you need to remember. If factor 13 is deficient, patient will have bleeding but a normal PT, ABTT. Because factor 13 is called fibrin stabilizing factor. It is outside the both extrinsic, intrinsic. Hence PT, ABTT will be normal but patient will be bleeding. Whereas factor 12 ka speciality kya hai? Agar wo deficient pad jaye to, there will be no bleeding but patient will have ABTT prolongation. Clinically there will be no bleeding but laboratory wise there will be ABTT prolongation. Reverse to what happens with factor 13 is what need to be remembered. Erythropoietin is produced by the interstitial cells of the kidney, peritubular capillary bed of the kidneys and the perivenous hepatocytes in the liver is what need to be remembered. Now, what is plasma? Normal plasma is about 5% of the body weight is what need to be remembered. Okay, doc. Shoot me an answer for this question. Bone tumor with chromosome 1122 translocation, which arises from the diaphysis. Let us ask you, which is that bone tumor which comes to your mind? Classically, which is associated with 1122 translocation is my question to all of you. You need to give me one answer. Which is located in the diaphysis.